Our next guest on the Business Roadshow owns an up-and-coming convenience store. Jose Miguel Ocampo Garcia is the CEO of Jago Mart, and they recently opened their 7th branch. Miggy is with us today to share his company's journey into the local convenience store scene and provide an outlook on the industry. Miggy, thank you so much for joining us. Welcome to the Business Roadshow.
Thank you for having me. You know, Ms. Denise, it's an honor to be here in this platform. Talk about the latest in the convenience stores.
Exactly, the latest in the convenience store industry, especially in the retail landscape. You know, how do you think the COVID-19 and its impact, especially its economical impact, has shaped the landscape now?
Well, you know, as everyone knows, convenience stores, it's always been there, you know. And this is actually something new for us also, for my company, you know. We started in different industries as well. We started in manpower, and we worked our way into logistics, and now we are into convenience stores. So the COVID-19 situation really, a lot of people are now more inclined to shop online, as we all know, because I think we're all part of this change, you know, as we move forward. And how it's affected a lot of different lives, as you can tell, you know, convenience stores, it's really there for quick and easy on the go food and different CVS items. So yeah, for the challenges, there are a lot of challenges, but what we're really looking forward is to looking for ways to find solutions for these.
Can you name, I guess, a couple of those challenges?
Yeah. Okay. Well, some of them are the following. No? In terms of supplies, inventory in stores. For us, especially since we're new, it's really gaining relationships, building relationships with these suppliers, so that they can see our store as a home for the goods as well. So that's one of the issues. Another one is really if we're coming up with a physical store. It's of course we're a startup, so we look at different locations, and rent could be a possible issue when it comes to opening stores. So that's another one to consider as well. Like I said, there are many issues, but the solutions is really what we're looking forward to.
I want to break down a lot of those answers. But first, you know, why suddenly go into convenience store? I mean, you said that you already were into other industries.
Yes.
So why break into something, I guess, that's quite tight? I mean, the competition.
Yes. So like I mentioned earlier, we started with manpower. It's actually a business that's been going on for 30 years. So that's called JG Manpower. And we went into logistics, which is JM Global Logistics. We opened 2018, and then we started serving one of the top dogs in convenience stores. So that's kind of where we were able to see the ins of the industry. And we were able to talk to different suppliers and build relationships as well. It just so happens that you know, during the pandemic, things didn't really end up the way we wanted to. There were some issues, like problems that we faced as we progressed with the partnership. And we decided to pull out. We were just also very lucky that we were at the right place at the right time. A lot of people who we've worked with really pushed us to open and start this venture. So we had full support of the suppliers and the people that we've worked with previously in the past company.
I mean, you're living really what you said, that you're not looking at the problems, you're focusing on the solutions.
Solutions,
after
correct.
That problem, you found a solution, and it's Jago Mart.
Yes.
So how are you, you know, what's the unique selling point of Jago?
Okay, so unique selling point, well, we really focus on our food. We want to be able to show support to the local community, and as well as support local is really something that we want to embody. It's one of our pillars, actually. So that's one thing. We are an all Filipino owned business in convenience. So the food that you will be having in our stores are the Filipino favorites, curated for the Filipinos as well, and for Jago, actually. It was us that came up with the ingredients and talk to our R&D team to actually create this food that you see on screen. Yeah.
I mean, congratulations on just opening your 7th branch. It's quite remarkable.
Yeah.
But can you tell us, I guess, where was the first store opening of Jago, and why did you choose that location?
Yes. So, like many small businesses, it's always a trial and error, right? And we opened our first store, our first convenience store in Sucat, actually. So this is in Doña Soledad. And this one is, it is located in our building. So we opened the space there and we just tried it out for the first time to see if there was potential in this venture. Thankfully, it was picked up and we were able to partner with a big company so that, you know, we were able to open in the different establishments and so forth. The store started opening and things just started moving quickly.
So where can we find the Jago branches right now? Where are the 7 branches?
Okay, so we have one in Sucat, as I've mentioned, Sucat Road. We have another one in Ayala Mall South Park. So this one is in Alabang. Mm-hmm. We also have one in a terminal, actually, the One Ayala Terminal in Makati.
In Makati,
yes.
Along EDSA.
Yes, yeah. Correct. So if you're commuting, especially if you land by the UV Express area, we're actually right in front of the terminal. So.
And where else? So that's 3. How about the other 4?
We have Cubao as well. So this is in 15th Street, Cubao.
Okay, I was wondering because I was like, we're seeing a lot of South here. How about the North?
Yes, we give love to the North as well. Yes. So we have that. We also actually have one in Cavite, in Trece Martires. So that's what, 6 already?
Yes, and then and the last one.
The last one is in Liip. Yes, so Liip, Laguna siya. Yes.
So what's, I guess, the strategy behind choosing these store locations?
Well, we have to look at a lot of different things, no? It's really the market that you have to look at. We want to open in locations where we're right beside or nearby a captured market, which are the BPO centers, manufacturing sites, because we operate differently also in a sense, like we offer programs. We tie up with different companies, and then we have a program wherein we basically tie up with the HR, and then their employees are eligible to, basically it's like a pa-utang situation. Situation wherein you can order, no, from the stores, and then we just deduct it also by the end of the month. So yeah.
And now, where are you seeing Jago going? Are there any other branch openings happening later this year?
Yes, actually, we're set to open 12 total by this year. So we're going to be opening in Market. That's another store that we're very excited for. We are also planning to open in South Woods, I believe. Yes, and. And Makati again, another one in Makati on De La Rosa Street. So there's a couple more stores that are in line. The team, we're very blessed to have a really good team on board this journey of ours to lead us towards that direction. And it's really a collaborative experience, you know, between different departments. And I can see how passionate they are. They don't just see Jago as a convenience store, but as a household brand name for the Filipinos.
Now, yes. You know, convenience store, they usually rely, I guess, on add-ons and also impulse buying.
Sure.
So how is Jago encouraging, of course, upselling and increasing the average transaction value?
Yes, actually, we really try as much as possible. We like to empower and train our staff in the stores. Once deployed, they're already equipped with the personality of a Jago, the embodiment of someone from Jago. So we really push them to, you know, be their full potential, to be able to sell, to sell rather our goods. So they really need to know what they are selling before they actually sell. So if the questions arise, they know how to answer it flawlessly.
Do you see, I guess, customer loyalty playing a huge role in the convenience store sector? Or, you know, as the name suggests, you know, convenience really is the biggest deal.
Yes, definitely. We do have different programs as well, such as the loyalty programs. So we do have...
So how does that work?
So you come into the store and we give you a card. And you basically come into the store 10 times and try different types of food that we have or whatever you've ordered at a certain amount, and then we give you a sticker. And every time you complete the 10, you get something from Jago, like a free meal, or we also have different prizes that we give to our loyal customers.
And now, Miggy, I mean, we're seeing the rise of e-commerce and the expansion of the modern grocery retail. So how do you think is that impacting traditional retail?
Yeah, as we know, there really it's everything is in the internet, right? Everything is on the phones, everything is on your screen. So traditional businesses, I believe, have to make that jump towards being online, because a majority of the market is already there. From retail to, actually, a lot of the industries are actually already there. So we have to find a way, and which we have, we've gone online as well. We're available in different platforms. So we join, let's say, for example, Grab is one of the platforms that we join that actually generate a good number of sales for us, because not a lot of people can go to the physical stores all the time. So we want to be able to extend our reach in certain areas by joining these platforms. And we're actually on the verge of completing our Jago Mart app. So that's another one that we're going to be launching most likely by next year.
And are you seeing, I mean, how are you doing the pricing strategy as well? I mean, convenience stores, of course, are known for its affordability.
Yes, correct.
So how is Jago's pricing strategy setting it apart from other competitors?
Yes. So what we do is we do our best to build good relationships with these suppliers. And, just trying to, in terms of the price ranges, we really like to place ourselves at the lower mark so that, I'll just let you know that some people, like when you enter the store, you're a little bit scared to see the price because the store looks very lit up, it's very beautiful. But what they need to see is the price ranges that we actually give out. It's very affordable for the average Joe. So that's really the market that we head towards. No, it's the CD market. Even if it looks a little bit more upscale and what we're trying to basically change or tweak the taste of the mass also by giving them the affordability, affordable prices. For them, yeah.
I mean, lastly also, you mentioned that when it comes to your staff and training them, they're the embodiment of course, Jago. Now, what is the vision, the brand image that you want people, your consumers to have of Jago?
Okay, so we use, ever since we started with Jago, we've always used the word kaibigan. Mm-hmm. So basically, we're your next door convenience store, na kaibigan. So we want to approach everybody with a warm smile, welcoming. Like especially with our staff, we really do our best to make sure that when people come in, they feel comfortable. They don't feel like the staff isn't paying attention to them. You know, if you enter a Jago store, you guys, I'm sure, will understand what I'm trying to say. Is you'll feel welcome and. You know, they are also, they're like a kaibigan. You know, they push you, they say, hey, you want to try this?
Which is quite new. I mean, convenience stores are really known for their self-service format.
Right. But that's what we want to bring to the table, is not just for people to do it themselves, but for them to have an extra hand. You know, like, you never know. If you enter a store, for me, when I enter a store and the service crew talks to me, I feel more at ease, because at least I know what I'm getting into. I know what I'm buying. I know what I'm eating. So that's basically what Jago Mart wants to do for the public. Also.
Definitely that personal touch. Miggy, thank you so much for joining us talking about Jago. We're so excited
for
all the other branch openings that you have in store for this year.
Yes, thank you so much, Ms. Denise.
Thank you.